this fucking toolbox is trying to roast me. One day I was skimming through social media and I found this video that piqued my interest.
Letting my fans control my life for 24 hours.
Here's the intro to the video. Oh, I get it. He's not talking throughout the video because his fans kept telling him to shut the fuck up. And I thought that was a funny meme, so I left this comment. This would have been more entertaining if you spoke more. I'm 5 and deaf. But then you responded with, at least my thumbnails look somewhat decent. So I replied back with, I would hope so. I just told you I was 5. If you can't understand jokes, then you're gonna have a tough time on YouTube, kid. And then you went on to say, what do you have to say about your channel then? I'm literally doing better than you. Collins, how did you get offended by my comment? I was making a simple joke. In fact, I roasted myself. I don't understand how you took my comment the wrong way, and you were so uptight about it. I was even trying to calm down the situation, but you just wasn't having it. Before we take a look at how much better you're doing than me, let me break down this fucking comment situation. Me calling myself 5 and deaf wasn't an insult towards you. You brought up thumbnails. I'll get into thumbnails later, but I guess you could say that was you trying to roast me. Me saying I would hope so, I just told you I was 5. Like, that should have told you I'm just here having a good time, kid. I'm not fucking criticizing you, because me being 5 would mean that I wouldn't be able to make a thumbnail at all or even comment on a video, let alone a full-ass sentence. And me saying, if you can't understand jokes, then you're gonna have a tough time on YouTube, kid. That wasn't advice. When I said tough time on YouTube, I wasn't talking about your channel. I was talking about the mentality. Like, you can't just be here taking shit the wrong way. And you doing better than me has nothing to do with anything that I said. So here we are now. I'm going to prove to you that numbers don't mean shit. Since you opened up the fucking gate to your glorious channel, let's take a look at one of your videos. Here you have a video titled Planting 20 Million Trees.
Morning and welcome back to the channel. I'm Colin. I do stuff and things on this channel. If you guys don't know what stuff and things is, well, if you subscribe, you'll learn to love stuff and things.
I am here to learn.
Today's gonna be hopefully an interesting day.
Spoiler alert, it's not gonna be interesting. Fuck! Jesus, dude!
Going in school now, I'm like, I'm gonna stop recording and then I'm gonna instantly cut to being out of school. I wish it was like that for me.
And there's the first joke of the video.
So this video right here is currently sitting at 100,000 views. That's crazy.
Look at those dislikes though. And the comments don't seem to look too pretty either.
Who just looked in the comments to see if it
Thank
actually
God
works.
I went through the comments before watching this.
Me,
I got
roses are red, ketchup is too. I just got clickbaited, so
you fucking idiot, go fuck yourself.
So if you guys did enjoy this vlog, I know it was a little, I don't know if you guys, yeah.
You really outdid yourself with all them trees. This is proof that clickbait isn't always successful. Like that one time you managed to get 150,000 views, but then you try to shitpost the same video again, except this time it didn't work. But I'll get into thumbnails later.
Welcome back to the only game show about thumbnails. Today's contestants are Egomaniac number 1 and Egomaniac number 2. Ah, yes, good shit. Today they'll be competing for nothing! Oh yeah, give a round of applause for the main prize of nothing! Huh. Oh man, how do we afford it?
For today's show, we went out in the public and we found 100 Slater Records fans and we asked them which thumbnail they liked the best. And yes, it was not easy finding that many fans of Slater Records. Let's jump right into the first category, and it is Fortnite. Colin's thumbnail is from Fortnite Season 8 Dances in Real Life! Fortnite Season 8.
and Slater Records brings Fortnite Chug Jug Challenge. Now let the timer begin. And the victory royale goes to Slater Records. I'm sorry, Collins. Maybe next round, but I don't know. I don't know. The next category is looking spicy. Collins presents us with a thumbnail from the video titled, Attempting the Most Dangerous Challenges. But Slater Records comes at us with the thumbnail from Super Duper Spicy Smoothie. Spiciest smoothie ever. Let the timer begin. Oh, I'm sorry, Collins. Maybe add a bit more spice next time. The last category will simply be titled Gone Wrong. Collins, what do you have? Okay. Hook at me, prank on mom! Gone Wrong. Now, Slaughter Records, what thumbnail do you got that is better? I mean, what thumbnail are you competing with? Oh, a classic! Blowtorch Cooking, Part 2, Gone Wrong. Damn, it looks like Slaughter Records is still on that pinnacle. But that's all the time we got. Maybe catch you next time. Tune in next time! Because this won't, even though this won't happen again.
Cameron just died, and it is the next day, so I completely forgot what I was talking about.
So I'm just gonna end the video.
I'm simply going through your videos right now. And I noticed you make a lot of videos about Lance Stewart. I know why Lance and Lizzie broke up.
She could have found out he was doing stuff in LA. When he went out there for a week, I think.
Stop trying to be Detective Pikachu over here. They broke up for views. At least that thumbnail was decent, though. You make videos about Lance Stewart unironically, but hey, you're literally doing better than me. You got hustle, so yeah, you got a shot at fame, but that doesn't mean your content isn't shit. Nobody call me salty. I'm just trying to give my fan base some quality content. And besides, I'm just taking notes. I'm trying to hit them colons numbers. If you like what you see, please like, subscribe, and dude, stop trying to roast me.